Welcome to FreeSQL Server online training. Today's class we are going to discussing on database configuration and maintenance. So in this chapter we are going to cover on SQL Server system databases and how the system SQL Server going to be stored all the information. Then we are going to discussing on data files. So before we discuss in the chapter, first we have to know what are the SQL Server system databases. Let me open here. When I open a SQL Server, I can easily find out the system databases. Here is the system databases: master, model, MSDB and TempDB. So these four system databases automatically install with the default of SQL Server installation. When you install a SQL Server, so all these four system databases install by default. So let's go and explain each and every database how it works in the system level. So before I explain about this master database, so we have to know all the database folder location drive. So if I create any kind of database or it's related to any kind of master or system databases, we have to know where the data is going to store. So here is the path, program files, Microsoft SQL Server, and this is the MS SQL 10. So this is the SQL Server 2008. So let me open this path and we can easy to find out. See here, I already open a path in my system. So all this database information, master, model and MSDB and TempDB. So even I created a test database. So those test database information also stored in this location. So this is the one of the important thing, the path where we have to store all the system or any database information. Let's go and discussing on the master database. So the master database, he is a heart of SQL Server. So what does it means? Without any master database, SQL Server will not start. That's what I explained in my slide here. If master database is corrupted or if it is not available, then the SQL Server service will not start. So that's why master database is heart of the SQL Server. Any kind of information, any activity which is related to the SQL Server, so that's automatically going to store in a master database. So here records all the system level information. Yes, that's true. When I open here in the master database, let me open here, I have a system views. So here, whatever the information related to the system, all the information going to be stored here. Either system programmers, that means system store procedures, or any kind of related information to the system level, that is all information going to be stored. Let me open here, for example, I want to show you what is the exactly system store procedure here. Let me take sp_voo2 active. So this is one of the system store procedures. I'm going to explain you in the next class. This is in the brief and security class. But I want to show you the just sample of system store procedure. So this is the system store procedure. So let me execute this query. So when I run this query, it shows all the SQL Server activity information. So what are the happening in a SQL Server, automatically it display here. Now we are already executing this store procedure. So this name is 54. This is the speed ID which is located to every activity in a SQL Server. So the same number, the 54, it display here, the Microsoft SQL Server query, who is running here in the Kranti is the system name, and the login name we already installed with the Kranti. So whatever any activity related to the system store procedure or any kind of system information automatically stored in a master database. So master database capture all informations like SQL Server instance level configurations, linker server configurations, SQL Server logins, service broker, system level store procedures. So any kind of which is related to the system level information automatically going to store in a master database. And if you connected any server or any instance, so instance means I can create a different name with the same SQL Server system configuration. I can explain in you in the installation of another instance. So every instance or every system SQL Server has an independent master database because this is related to particularly system information. So every master model MSDB and TempDB has independent to each SQL Server. So now let me go and explain in the model database. So model database is another level of system database. So here the model database use a template when creating a database in a SQL Server. Let me open here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to open a new database. What I click on the right. So here new database. So I'm going to give any kind of database name. Like let me give you the Kranti. So before I installation or before I create a database, I have some templates here, right? The row type, file systems or options, everything. This is the one of the template before I install. So once I give the name, automatically give the name of all information with the particular database name. So what does it mean? The model database can store all the templates and models. Suppose if you want to create any procedure or anything, let me open here new procedure. So when I click it, so I can give a procedure name here, give a procedure name as a Kranti. I create a procedure name. Some of the templates already displayed here, right? So this is the one of the model or template soon to be stored in a model database. That's what is explaining here, used as a template when creating a database in a SQL Server. If the model database is damaged or corrupt in the SQL Server, so the SQL Server will not start up as it will not able to create the TempDB databases. Model database, suppose if the model database is damaged or corrupted. So if I click the model database, before I give the name, so all this information temporarily going to be stored in a TempDB databases. TempDB database, what does it mean exactly? TempDB means temporary storage. For example, if we suppose let's go and create a new database. So before we create a new database or before we give any kind of information in the database, all this information temporarily going to be stored in a TempDB. This is the template model. This model is already stored in a model database. So when I click give in the name Kranti, so now this is a temporary purpose right now because we did not click on OK button. That means this is a temporary storage. So these temporary storage information going to be stored in a TempDB. Right? So that means if master database is not there or if master database is corrupted, so then the temporary database is not allowing to store. So now let's coming to MSDB database. So MSDB database store information related to the configuration of SQL Server agent jobs, job schedules, alerts and operators. We already discussed in the SQL Server installation class. So we have already some four services. So one is SQL Server agent. So the jobs or alerts, operators, any kind of information related to the SQL Server agent services, automatically this information going to be stored in a MSDB database. So what is the main purpose of this SQL Server agent? I can explain you some sample in a job, what does it mean and how it works in a SQL Server. For example, I have a SQL Server procedure. So that is going to be take 1 hour for execution on every day. So I want to schedule the job in a midnight of 2 o'clock. So every day to midnight of 2 o'clock, I don't need to wake up. So what I am going to do, I have to schedule a job at that particular time. Then I can schedule it and automatically SQL Server run the job at exactly at the 2 o'clock in the morning. So let me give here the job name is, for example, Kranti, and I can give the schedule of the job. So here the recurring or one day or anytime, I can weekly or monthly. So this is the schedule. So that means any kind of related to the jobs or alerts. Alerts means if any job fails, automatically send a SMS or send a message to you by the alert. So all these kind of jobs, alerts and error logs and operators. So which is coming under the SQL Server agent. So all the SQL Server agent services, jobs and information going to be stored in a MSDB. Right? So we already discussed here master database, model and MSDB. Now let's come into the temporary database. Temporary database is storage of temporary purpose. For example, if we create any procedure or if the job runs, let me explain you here. I have a job run at 2 a.m. So then how the job works is every day inserting 200 million records. 200 million records in a particular table. So when the procedure and the job running at midnight 2 a.m. So before install all the 200 million records, it's installed one by one, right? It's like every time, let's assume every time, every second, 100,000 records are inserting into a particular table. So every time up to reach of 200 million records, that all the information temporarily stored in a tempdb. So once the operation is completed to insert 200 million records, then all the information going to be stored in a particular table. But before you insert all the 200 million records, so until finish that, all the information is going to be stored in a temporary DB. Everybody got the point here? Temporary DB is only for the temporary storage. So let me explain you in a general scenario. Let's come here. I have a room that name is A, and today is my last day, so that's why I'm going to vacate my room and A. And I'm going to move room B that is available on after 2 days. So before I have to move from A to B, I need some space to storage for 2 days, right? So here, this is my storage for temporary purpose on 2 days. So before I have to go from A to B, I have to bring my all stuff from A to put it in a storage for 2 days. Then after 2 days, then all my stuff from storage to going to be stored in a B location. So that means before we move into A to B, all the information and everything going to be stored for a temporary purpose. So at the same way, when you work in the SQL Server, before and after the completion of work, all the information going to be stored in a temporary purpose. So all the temporary purpose information is going to be stored in a temporary database. So after this database, system databases, let me explain you one more time here. We already discussed in the 4 system databases. One is master, model, MSDB and tempdb. Master database is a heart of SQL Server. So any kind of system information automatically stored in a master database. And when you come into the model database, if you want to create any kind of database or system procedures, whatever it is, related to templates, all the templates and model information already stored in a model database. When you come into the MSDB database, all the information which is under related to the SQL Server agent services, jobs or schedules, all this information stored in MSDB database. Then after, when you come into the temporary database, each and every information after the starting and before complete, all information stored in a temporary databases. See here, store all the temporary objects such as temporary tables, global temporary tables, temporary stored procedures, cursors, so any kind of related, so stored in a temporary purpose. So all the temporary purpose information stored in a temp database. Okay, so now let's come into the pages and extents. Okay, now every information here we already open or I execute the procedure. So these are all information, right? All activity information from the SQL Server. So all information, whatever I suppose if I click execute button, so here procedure and the output results and the message and any kind of information activity in a SQL Server. So automatically the data is stored, right? So once I click the execute button or when I get the results, so this is all are under the SQL Server operation. So now let's come into the pages and extents. So before, we have to explain the pages and extents. We should have to know some information in a SQL Server. So if you, we have to do any kind of information, let's assume here I execute the procedure. So when I execute the procedure, I got some results and I got some output message and I executed some information here. So all this information automatically stored in a particular location, right? Every SQL Server activity must be stored in a particular place and particular format. So all this activity and every kind of information stored in a format of pages. Just like as our Word document. See, if I type it any kind of information, so all our information is stored in a Word document by order. So once I complete this page, automatically goes into the next page. Right? So every kind of information stored by in a order and once you finish the page, automatically going to the next page. So why is going to next page? Because this is enough space already completed in a one page. So once you completed the one page, then remaining information going to be stored in another extra page. Same similar way, so all information going to be, let's complete after the second page, it automatically goes to the third page. At the same way, all the SQL Server information stored in a page level and by format of same like as a Word document. So once you completed, automatically goes into the next page. And if so here, the same like as a Word document, we have a header and footer, right? We have a header and footer. The Word document had allocated some space for a header and footer. At the same way, when you come into the SQL Server, the data stored in a particular format and there is some space for the page header and footer. So here, so each page has a size of 8096 bytes. So then each page has a 8 KB size of free space and each page is 96 bytes for header. If you, because why we need a header? Suppose if I enter my any information, we have to display the page number, right? So here this is the second page. Let's assume this is the second page. So once I completed here, I have to go into the another page, right? So once this is the second page, now then after I have to go into the another page. So I need to display the page number same like as a 3. So every information which is related to the header, so automatically SQL Server allotted 96 bytes for header and 8 KB size for the free space. So in 8 KB size, automatically whatever we activity do in a SQL Server, any kind of information automatically stored in a free space of 8 KB. Everybody got the point here? The SQL Server store the information in a format of pages. So pages is nothing but our Microsoft Word document. So it stores one by one. Once we completed the space of first one page, then automatically goes into the next page. So then every time SQL Server allocated the free header space for 96 byte and the remaining of 8 KB size automatically stored in a data. The total size of each page is 8096 KB. So this is one of the important question in an interview. What is the page maximum size? Okay, so now let's come into the page types, because now we only executed the just only for text document. Suppose some of them we can insert image or any kind of related information or any kind of activity. Here the data, because we already executed in the text data here, so all this information stored in a data page type. So data rows with all the data except text and image data. When you come into the index, so index topic will come into the next chapter in a performance tuning. So all this index information stored in an index page, and it which is any related to the image or text automatically stored into the image page type. Okay, so these are the some different types of page types. So if you need, you can read it by in the Microsoft Server website. So they will explain you briefly. So any kind of information, it's already in the Word. See, differential change in map. So information, I can explain you the extent now. What does it mean of extent? Okay, so now let's come into the extent here. So space is allocated to the tables and indexes, and extent has 8 pages. So here there is a clearly indication. One extent and extent has 8 pages. So what does it mean? Suppose if my data is filled up to 8 pages, so that called one extent. We already discussed on the page here, the page SQL Server stored in a page format with a 8 KB size. This is the one page. So up to 8 pages has a extent 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these all 8 pages included called as a one extent. Okay. So extent is nothing but a 8 pages. So now when you come into the extent, there is a two types of extents. What does it extend? Two types of extents. Suppose if I want to enter information about mine, so I'm going to enter in my information in one page, like all my information related to the Kranti Kumar. So my information up to I fill it up here. Information, I have some more information. So then after the next time, automatically allocated to the next page. Okay, so here I enter my all information. Again, I have some more information too. So I have more and more information. So when after fill it up this one, I'm going to enter some more information allocated to the next page. So here any kind of related to the table information or any same information going to be stored in a different pages by the same format. See, so uniform extents are owned by single object. All 8 pages in the extent can only be used by the owning object. So that means any kind of similar same information going to be stored. So what does it mixed in extends? Told you all my same information stored in a different pages with the same object information. Instead of that, already my information is done in the middle, and I am going to enter another information, another person. So same kind of information, another Raj person is combined with this the same page. So this is not the same object. This is Raj, for example, as a different object. Mine is different object. So here the data is stored in a different objects. It's not the same object. So that means that is called a mixed extents. So that is the meaning of uniform extents are owned by the single object. But when you come into the mixed extents are shared by up to 8 objects. So that means here see, the mixed extent means table 1, this is another object, and index is another one, index 2 is another one, again table. But when you come into the uniform extent, that means all are same objects, table 1, table 1, table 1. So this is all information related to table 1 stored in a single uniform extent. But when you come into the mixed extent, is stored in a different objects. One is table 3, one is table 2, and index 1 and index 2. We discuss here page and extent. So page is nothing but a storage of SQL Server. So each page has 8 kilobyte size, and 96 byte size is a header for pages. So each and every information stored in a page format by page header. And when we come into the extent, each page, so total 8 pages called one extent. And when you come into the mixed extents, so there is a different object stored in a 8 one extent format, because one extent means we called as 8 pages. So in this 8 pages stored and a different objects, table 2, index 1. So these are the different objects. So that means mixed extents. So when you come into the uniform extent, that means all the same object related information stored in a one extent, means total 8 pages, that's called a uniform extent. Okay, now let's come into the create a database. This is a basic topic, and this is a basic task too. So if you want to create your one database, what I have to do, I have to go and right click here, create a new database, and let me give a database name. So once I give the database name, so there is automatically default data file groups, files here, right? So before I have to give a name, already the SQL Server showing the files and file groups. So this is the default file. So these are the default files. One is data file and another one is log file. Before I give any database name or before I create a new database, so automatically default has a SQL Server two files. One is data and another one is log file. Suppose let me give here the database name. So when come here, automatically create a data file and log file. Okay, so here is a path for log storage of files. So any kind of related, suppose if you create any database, so automatically default create two files. One is data file and log file. So all this information stored in this path. If you need to change the path, you can change it. So let me copy it here. And then we can let me create a first and database. Let me click on OK. So now the database is automatically created. So let me open the path, then we can easy to find out. So here, once I open a path, so now once we create a database, here this is the data file and this is the log file. So the same path which we stored here. Once I create a database, so let me open a properties, and then it shows there in the files our file path. And once we create a database, it's automatically default has a data and log files. Okay, so the same path we open here. So once we after we creating a database, all that data file and log file stored here. So that's what is going to be explained here. Once you created database, so the default files are log files and data files, and the file extension path .mdf. Okay, let me open here the files. So here, once I create a file, we have an extend file name, right? Data file, that means .mdf. And when you come into the log file, the file extension is .ldf. So once I create a database, automatically default has a two files, data and log file, and the extension of data file is .mdf, and when you come into the log file, .ldf. So these two files automatically default when you create a database. If I want to add one more data file, there is no log file. Log file is only unique log file. We cannot create a multiple log files. We create only multiple primary data files. So let me give one name, Kranti1. Click on OK. So let me open a properties again. Files. See, this is the default data file .mdf. And this is the log file .ldf, and I created another secondary file, the secondary primary secondary file, that means called extension of .ndf. So that means the secondary data files make up all the data files other than the primary data file. So the primary data file, when you create a database, it's a default one. Is a primary data file is .mdf. So after this, if I want to create some more files, so one that's called it secondary files extension of .ndf. Okay, so we already discussed here how to create a database and what are the data files. So already we already discussed how to create a database. So once we create a database, what are the data files come under the creation of database? So we already discussed the extension of data, primary data file, secondary data file and log files. So once you create a data file, automatically these primary data file and log file are the default ones. Okay, so here file groups, we already discussed on the files in the database. Once we create a database, automatically the default data files are there. So when you come into the file groups, so this is the primary file group is a default one. Once you create a database, automatically the primary file group is a default one. See here, this primary file group. So files and file groups are different. File means single file. File group means combination of files. So when you come into the SQL Server default, the primary data file group is automatically installed when we create a database. So here we created two data files, one is secondary and primary. So when we come into all two data files is under the primary file group, right? So here if you want to add a secondary file group, you have to give the name secondary file group. If you want to click as a secondary file group as a default, you can click, otherwise you can ignore it. So let me click on OK, open a properties and file groups. I have a two file groups here, primary and secondary. So now what I am going to do is I am going to add another extra secondary data file. And I am going to give the file group name is a secondary, because we already declared here. Keep in mind file and file groups. File is a single file. File group is a combination of files. So when we come into here, the primary file group is a default with the SQL Server. The secondary file group is we can create it ourselves, and it's display the how many number of files under the secondary file group. So already we here, there is a two primary file groups. The two files are under a primary file groups. So let me add it one more. Another extend of data file, I can give as secondary file groups. So let me file groups here. See, the secondary file group is two files. Let me click OK and open a properties. So all the files, so this is the primary data file .mdf which come as a default, log file as .ldf, so all the secondary files .ndf, and I created two file groups. One is primary is automatically default one, and secondary I created. So what, how many number of files coming to primary file group? That means two, and the secondary file group has a two. So that means file is a single file and file group is a combination of files. Okay, so here the primary file group, each database has only one default file group. Yes, that's true. I already explained here. When I come into OpenSQL Server, this is the primary data file group which is come as a default one. So the primary file group has a already default data file. So once we create a database, automatically created as a .mdf file. So this .mdf file has primary file group. So then contains the primary data file with all system objects, system tables, system information. Yes, that's true. Let's go and open our system databases here. Let me open a properties. So when I open a click here, .master.mdf file, that is a default one data file. So all the our system information is stored into the .mdf file, which is related to master database. So here, the same scenario, user defined file groups. User defined file group is nothing but when I created a secondary file group, that's called a user defined file groups. This is the user defined file group. So when you come into the file groups, there is a two types of file groups. First one is primary file group and user defined file group. So primary file group has a default one and which contain must have a one data file. That is a primary data file is coming with a default of creation database. So user defined file group, so we can create a user defined file groups. So we can create a zero or more user defined file groups.